Hi, hi, and welcome to Strap a Watch. I'm Michael Knapp with Michael Knapp Leather. Well, I got a really cool build out today on this brand new Haida alligator skin that I just got in stock out of my tannery that I use strictly today. It's called American Tanning and Leather LLC out of Griffin, Georgia. I'm going to highlight them here in a little bit, but they call this their Azul Real Blue Alligator. And this is for Mr. Jason Cole out of the Cole Automotive Group. He's got this bluey Submariner right here. And I believe it's a late 80s vintage. He said 87, 88, somewhere around there. And he sent me this example of the blue alligator on a yellow. No, that's not my work, but yellow stitching. And, you know, at the time I didn't have a blue color he was happy with. And I had a couple other guys chomping at the bit for a different shade of blue alligator. So that's why I got this. I contacted everybody, sent them some shots of the hide before I pulled the trigger and bought it. And they were all very happy with the color. So that's why I've got this now in stock. I can actually also dye this to make it midnight blue. So anybody looking at maybe doing a midnight blue. But here's American Tanning and Leather's website. You can see they've been in business for 100 years as a family-owned and operated business. It does cost me a little bit more to go through these guys, but the quality is the best I have ever found. And they have a great grading system. Whoever is doing all the grading, they know what they're doing. And I only utilize grade 1 or 1/2 alligator hides. And, you know, a lot of times people think, well, how is that graded? It's graded on the size of the scales, actually, the quality of the skin itself, and also the sizing. And so of the overall belly area is really what they're sizing it based on. And that's in centimeters. But here's the Horween Shell Cordovan, navy blue Horween Shell Cordovan leather linings. Double checking the order right there to make sure I got the right size. Jason's got a little bit bigger of a wrist. But yeah, I hope to someday visit American Tanning and Leather. Griffin, Georgia is only about 6 hours away from where I'm at here in the Jacksonville, Florida area. So I'm going to try and really make that happen. I got to tell you guys a little backstory on this. This is called an arbor press that I utilize to not only emboss my logo, which I'm doing here, but it's also how I cut the point ends. So at the bottom of that block that's coming down on that leather stamp of my logo, I can also put these cutting elements. They're magnetized and they hold in, and then I you know, different sizes and shapes of cutting elements to cut the point end. Well, about a week and a half ago, I was getting ready to cut a point end off of a leather strap order, and there's an Allen screw that holds all that in place that came loose a good month ago. And I knew it. I just hadn't gotten around to tightening it yet. I brought down an Allen keys to tighten it, but it was the wrong size. I didn't have the actual size I needed. So I just said, all right, I'll get it fixed when I get there. Well, as I'm cutting this point end, it came loose, and the whole thing fell on my thumb with the cutting element and almost cut my thumb off. Talk about scared. I'll tell you, man, I have cut myself so many times while working on leather. You know, a lot of times you're going too fast with a knife or do something just stupid, or you're tired. But this was just, it happened so fast and so unexpected. And when it, you know, I'm first looking down at my thumb, basically the inside corner was hanging off. And if the element hadn't hit the bone, it would have just cut it completely off. So, yeah, I'm doing okay now. I just, you know, let everybody know. I thank God, because it could have been way worse than it was. And I really appreciate Blake. I was working on your strap when it happened, and I contacted you, and thank you for understanding, and, you know, and also, I mean, I contacted a couple other people, because I had to take a week off. I would have been, kind of ahead of the game. I was really getting caught up on strap orders where I was, hovering around 6 to 8 week turnaround time, and I was getting down to about 4 to 6 weeks. Well, now I'm good 8 weeks again. So I apologize to everybody. Thank you for being patient and understanding, but I do have a little bit of nerve damage. I can tell because it's very kind of prickly in that area. But all the, everything's okay. Everything's okay. No infection. That was kind of my biggest worry. But I'm doing much better. And, getting back to the strap build, another thing just for Jason and anybody ordering that has maybe a vintage Rolex. We didn't really take this into account, Jason. I apologize. But we got this with curved spring bar lug pins. And you're going to see me, here real shortly forming all of that. And we probably could have gotten away with traditional lug pins on this. The problem is in modern Rolexes, the pinholes are so close to the watch head and the bezel is very sharp and rounded and protrudes into that area that no matter what, it leaves a mark right at that folded area of the strap where you fold the lug pins over. And there's enough clearance because I noticed, not until you sent me pictures, which are included here at the tail end of this video, of the final product of it on his watch on his wrist. And so what I'm saying is we could probably get away with putting in traditional 20 millimeter lug pins. So if you want me to, I'll send you some of those. But right here is how I do it. This is how I form putting in curved lug pins. And that, little piece of metal that's going through there is actually, for you leather crafters should know, is from a dauber, which we use to dye leather. It has a wool rounded ball on the end that I snipped off with some wire cutters and then bent it in that curved shape to make the curved mold of the spring bar lug pin area. And then after the whole final product said and done, I just slipped the spring bars in there. So Jason, we could probably get away with putting in some traditional 20 millimeter lug pins if you wanted to. I didn't notice that until you sent me, like I said, the final product, but I'm pretty sure we can do that for you. Here I'm putting in the stitching holes with my pricking irons. Those are 3.38. A lot of leather crafters contact me, what size spacing do I utilize with my pricking irons? And so here we are with that yellow stitching, like I was showing you earlier, what he wanted to do to kind of highlight the gold on the two-tone bluey. And to me, it's kind of U of M, University of Michigan colors. And I'm a Michigan State Spartan, so they're, a big rival of ours. And that's okay. But yes, if you like the show, please hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't. Hit the bell notification, all those things really do help out. And just much appreciated. Here we go, final product. He also ordered this, as you can see, an aftermarket Rolex pin buckle. But boy, if that doesn't scream University of Michigan, I don't know what does. So maybe, I don't know, maybe Jason went to school there too. So yeah, I'll have to find that out. But here's the reverse side. You can see my logo and you can really now see the curved spring bars. But you'll notice that here in a moment. Jason had just sent me these wrist roll shot and I finalized that on Valentine's Day. That's pretty cool. I didn't notice that till just now. But here's an edge shot. I've been doing these kind of recently where you can really see the taper, 2.5 millimeter pads in there. Some guys get really kind of bent out of shape about pads. They're like, oh, that's really thick, 2.5 millimeters. No, it's not. Here it is on his wrist. So that's what I'm saying. You can kind of see where with the curved spring bars, it's almost too much of a gap now. This is a vintage watch head from Rolex, so the pinholes are just much further out than I expected, and I apologize for that. Let me know. He still says it's great. He loves it. Great work, he said. But here's the wrist roll shot. Really appreciate you doing this for us, Jason. But you can see how well it matches the gold and the blue bezel and dial. Really cool. Really cool. I've got a lot of guys that have now ordered this Azul Real Blue Alligator. And here's one last look at this strap. I think it's gorgeous. I just love the color of this blue alligator. Well, listen, you guys, I really appreciate everything. Thanks for understanding about and being patient with my thumb. And God bless you all. Until next time, keep on ticking.